Hey everybody, it's John with Freshwater Systems. Today we're going to talk about the biggest water issue in the country, and it's called hard water. And we're going to talk to you about the solution for creating soft water with a water softener, an ion exchange water softener. We're going to talk about the problems that hardness creates and the best way to get rid of it. So let's begin by talking about what is hard water. Hard water is created by the mineral content in the water. Typically, it's calcium and magnesium. And when water percolates down through the soil and picks up the different minerals that are in the ground, calcium and magnesium are abundantly available, usually in the Earth's crust. And any water source that comes out of the ground typically has a fair amount of these hardness-causing minerals. Water that contains an abundance of this mineral is severely hard, by definition. And what happens is these minerals want to come out of solution relatively quickly. And if you have any hardness in your water, you know what it looks like. When you boil water, it's that white crust that stays behind. It forms on your shower head and it accumulates in your water heater. And it actually makes a problem in any hot water using appliance. Water hardness is a difficult problem to deal with. It bonds with soaps and creates that scummy curd that sticks to the shower curtain or the shower door. So it's aesthetically a big nuisance. So if you have hard water, you know you have hard water, and you spend a lot of time dealing with hard water effects. You spend a lot of time cleaning the shower door, cleaning your pots and pans, dealing with a dishwasher that you have to outrun scale and erosion of the glassware. You spend a lot of time with laundry. Hardness beats up laundry. It makes your clothing dingy. It makes your towels scratchy because those minerals are embedding themselves in the fabric. There's a lot of cost associated with hard water. In fact, many of your soaps and detergents, the very first ingredient, are water softening agents. And we like to refer to this as you're softening your water already. It's either by addition or subtraction. And when you have a product like a soap or a detergent where the very first ingredient is meant to deal with water hardness, that's addition. By using a water softener, that's subtraction. We're getting rid of minerals so that you don't have to buy extra products to clean for them. Studies have shown that 20% of every dollar you spend at the grocery store is spent on cleaning supplies and items. A point of entry water softener solves all these problems, and it's actually going to save you money. And if you have severe hardness, just softening the water will pay for the water softener in as little as a few years. Now, a water softener is not really a filter. But what it does is it's going to remove, by ion exchange, all of the hardness-causing minerals. And the reason that we put it at the point of entry is it protects all of your appliances, all of your plumbing and fixturing throughout the house. Inside the mineral tank in a water softener, it's loaded with resin. And this ion exchange resin is exchanging hardness mineral ions with sodium ions. The resin looks like this. It's thousands of these small, tiny spheres, these resin beads, and that is where the hardness minerals are attracted to and captured by this resin. Well, in all of that resin, they will get exhausted as the water passes through the bed, the column. Once they're exhausted, the ion exchange water softener goes into a cycle we call regeneration. And next to the water softener is a tank full of salt. And it mixes with water in the very bottom. And that salt and water create a brine solution. The brine solution is then drawn up through this column of resin, and the ion exchange reverses where the minerals that cause hardness are released, and it grabs a hold of the sodium ions. And in this process, it regenerates the resin beads, so they're ready to take hardness minerals out again. And all of those hardness minerals that are released go right down the drain. Now, just if you want to know specifically how much sodium is added by a water softener, the equation is kind of simple. So if you have 10 grains of hardness in your water supply, you multiply that by 2, and that's roughly how much sodium milligrams you'll get in an 8-ounce glass of water. So if we have 10 grains of hardness times 2, we're going to add 20 milligrams to an 8-ounce glass of water. The maximum daily allowance of sodium is somewhere between 1,500 and 2,000. And 20 milligrams is not large in the grand scheme of sodium consumption through the day. If sodium is a problem for you, even minor amounts of sodium, then a reverse osmosis system under your sink will eliminate not only the sodium that's added by the water softener, but also the naturally occurring sodium that you might have in your water supply. Now, some water softeners work more efficiently than others in the regeneration process. Cocurrent means that it's going to go in the same direction as service. And in our water softener, that's from the top down. And then there's countercurrent. That means that the brine is going to be introduced to the resin column in the opposite direction of the service flow. And that would be from the bottom up. The efficient way to do it is countercurrent. And the reason for that, when we're cocurrent regenerating, we're running the salt through the resin column in the same direction as service flow. And all of that hardness mineral is being pulled off of the resin beads and sent to the drain, which unfortunately is at the bottom, the flow to the bottom. In doing so, all of the hardness that's being released at the top of the column is re-exchanging on the bottom of the column. So we just got to keep putting salt to it to make sure that our resin bed gets clean. In countercurrent, by moving the brine solution from the bottom to the top of the resin column, all of that hardness is just going out and not being reintroduced to the resin, which means we use less water and less salt, and we've got much more efficiency in our regeneration cycle. And that's the type of softener that you need to look for. And then on top is the control valve. The control valve is the brains of the operation. It meters how much water goes through the unit and calculates when it's time to do the regeneration cycle. It also maintains a programmability so that you can make the thing go off or regenerate when you need it to. And it's a good note to schedule the regeneration cycle when no one will be using water. Water softeners can soften and they can regenerate, but they can't do both at the same time. So typically they're factory set to go at 2:30 in the morning. Now, if you work midnights, you would want to set that at a different time. Well, that's all I've got for water softeners today. Be sure and give us a call if you have any questions, you need help sizing, or you need some additional water treatment items to go with it. Pre-treatment, or if you're on a well, you should have ultraviolet disinfection if you don't already. Give us a call. Be sure and like our video, subscribe to our channel, and check us out at freshwatersystems.com.